Hello and welcome to Taboretum channel. Today we'll be talking about threads and how to design them for 3D printing. I will be using, as usual, FreeCAD to do that. Obviously, this is a thread on a screw. Also, this is a thread, a plastic screw. Ah, this is a strange one, but it's also a thread. Kind of obvious thing, but on a bottle, you also have a screw here. And you actually may have a 3D printed screw, 3D printed thread here. And inside, some more threads. A thread here, a metric one on a bolt, and a wood screw. So all these are threads. And what we will do today, let's do some cleanup. We'll work on my Comandante grinder. And the problem I have is that this container at the bottom fits around 36, 38 grams of grinded coffee. And if I want to grind more, I can still fit more beans here, but they don't fit underneath. So I would like to have a slightly bigger container. And yet another thread. We have a thread here. Let me clean this up a bit and we will measure it. We have few parameters of a thread. So fairly basic one would be the diameter of this container with no thread, which is 54-ish, right? Then the diameter outside 60.42, and that's, you can see the shape. And I can double check on the Comandante itself. What is the diameter of it? Yeah, it is the same thing, 60.27, and you can see that this is a real thing with a real bits of coffee over there. And now the interesting part, we would like to know what is the pitch of this thread. So what's the distance between these two thread lines? And it looks like it's around 4 mils, which is probably right because these threads usually are metric stuff. One more thing that I will measure is actually the width of this thread, which is 2 millimeters. And I would also like to know what's the current size of this. So let's measure it with the thread part. So this is 61.5, and this thread part here is around 1 centimeter. Well, yeah, it's probably less than that. It's closer to 9 mils. Okay, so we have basic measurements and let's get to the design part.
We start with a fresh body. Now we create sketch in the XZ plane. We use the magic tool to create a polyline and we start from here. So we have the bottom part. Then we go up. And edged here a bit more up, back to the axis, and whoops, now we need to move and connect here. So that's it, and now we add some constraints. This should be 27 as far as I remember our measurements. This should be 30. This, let's make it a bit funny, make it 69 because it should be a bit longer than the original thing. I believe this gentleman there was 9 mils. And now we will just use the angle as the last thing we want here. And this angle let's make it 45, which is a safe angle to print. So that's basically it. One more thing we want to do here. Let's make this corner round to make it softer, and let's say 4, radius 4 mils. And that's our basic shape. So let's close and let's do a revolution. And that's it. That's the container shape. No, let's say inside yet. We can do that later on. And or we can print it in a vase mode or in a fake vase mode. And now we need to add our thread. What we do, we go to the front and we create yet another sketch in XZ plane. And this sketch, let's import external geometry. This sketch will sit here, and this will be basically a triangle. Yeah, so let's make it a triangle like here. Let's make it a round corner and another point here. We will connect these two. See, we have some redundant constraints, so let's get rid of it. Yeah, and now as far as I remember, this one was 2 millimeters. We measured that. And these two actually should be equal. And the angle between these two should be 60 degrees. That's the typical metric thread. And last thing here is the radius of this gentleman here. We can make it 0.5, let's say, to make it nice and round. And we can anchor these, let's say, from here to here. This will be, let's make it 1.5-ish. And now we have the cross section of our thread. We close, and what we now want to do, we want to rotate it, but go up, which is a helix shape. And here we have the additive helix. We press it, and magic happens. We have our thread. It's too long because it's goes above the whole thing. But remember that we can switch to pitch turns, and we will define the pitch and number of turns. Our pitch was 4 mils, and we only want one turn, and that's it. And you have this cone angle here that what is happening, you see, it is actually wrapping it on a cone rather than on the regular finger. But you will see in a second how these actually can be useful. So here is our thread. And the last thing I want to do that I don't like about it is that I want a nice finish of these elements. And to do that, I actually create another additive helix using this face. And it will do something stupid, that the whole thing will disappear, because it tries to make this, you see, in some strange way. But if we tell it back that it should be using the Z axis, it works now. And we want to keep the pitch of 4 mils, and just a little piece of this, and use this cone angle to actually sink this thread in the whole body. And 78, I think, yeah, it's the right number. So it's now smooth, sexy, and I love it. And let's do the same thing with this face. But this time, yeah, again, the whole thing will break a bit, because it will try to do it in a strange place. But we tell it, make it Z-axis. Make it actually 4 mils. Make it 0.3 length, and make it reverse, because we want to go backward. And we can type -78, because that's now a golden number. And ta-da! We have our super cool, super duper ending for the thread. And now, if you would like to go to make the inside of it, the easiest way actually is to create yet another sketch in XZ plane,
And the reason why I'm not doing the original sketch narrow, right, is that these extra bits that went in will be actually visible on the inside if we made it thin enough. However, yeah, there are two options. Either we cut the inside or we change this original sketch. But my idea is that we will cut it. So again, we create the sketch here in the intersection, actually. And yeah, we can toggle off this for now and just turn on the original sketch. And what we want to do, we want to create similar thing. I want the bottom to be slightly thicker, so the whole thing is stable. And this here can be fairly narrow because it's just a wall. Maybe I want to make these out of two arcs, so when the coffee is coming out, it will be smooth. And now I go here, back to the edge, and down. And let's just assume this is the right shape. We can actually, again, import the external geometry and put our point on this one, because otherwise it will not cut through. And that's roughly it. And what we do now, we close. We have our cool new sketch inside. We can turn on the view. And what we do, we actually do a groove using this sexy button. And you see, we have inside now. So we have our beautiful container fully designed and ready. Let's turn on the sketch. So now we can actually slice it and print it out. Now we are in the PrusaSlicer. This is our container. And we want to make it pretty quick. And we want a bit higher infill because I want the bottom to be thicker. So let's slice and have a look and then print it out. So here we have, you can see the bottom is a bit thicker as planned, then pretty thin wall. And then we end up with the nice thread at the top. And we print it on my NT5 with my nice orange PLA filament. And here we are. This is our container 3D printed with a nice thread over here and these, you know, start and end that we carefully designed. And here is my Comandante grinder. Let's make a test. Yeah, fits perfectly, sits perfectly, and is slightly bigger than the original one, which is exactly what I wanted. Maybe I can smooth it a bit because you can see the seam here, but it was rather a POC. Not sure if this is the right color for my kitchen. However, you have learned how to actually design a thread and 3D print it. So thanks for watching. Happy designing and happy printing. Cheers. Bye-bye.